power and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages. Amen.
Thank you. Be attentive unto my help, O Lord of my salvation. Forsake not, O Lord, my God, depart from me. Be attentive unto my help, O Lord of my salvation. O God, my God, unto thee I turn and go. I saw the fruit of thee. Often I've met the flesh, all I've met thee, Lord, in the land, buried my toil and mortuary. So I'm ashamed of thee before I didn't see that power of my glory. For thy mercy is better than life, and I shall praise thee. So shall I bless in my life, and in the name of the Lord, lift up my hands. And the prayer of my heart, let my soul be filled. And with lifted joys, and shall my mouth praise thee. If I remember thee, I'll get up to dawn, and I'll sit on thee. For thou art become my hope, and the shelter of wings, for I rejoice. My soul hath thanked after thee. Thy right hand hath been quick to help me. But as for thee, the name of Israel after my soul, they shall go down into the pit, both parts of the earth. They shall be surrounded and shed as a sword. Fortunes shall fall to shatter thee. But the king shall be glad in God, everyone shall be praised as far as by him. For the mouth of them is stout to speak unjust things. After dawn, may I feed on thee with that become my helper. In the shelter of thy wings will I rejoice. My soul hath thanked after thee. Thy right hand hath been quick to help thee. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Both now and ever, and to ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to thee, O God. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Both now and ever, and to ages of ages. Amen. O Lord God, my salvation, my day, and my kindness, and my difficulty, let my prayer come before thee.
let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the
Lord.
For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and for those with faith, reverence, and the fear of God entered therein, let us pray to the
Lord.
For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the
Lord.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the
Lord.
For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities and for armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Andrew, Benjamin, Thaddeus, Connor, and Skylar, let us pray to the
Lord.
For the city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the
Lord.
For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those in a persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the
Lord.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
God is the Lord, the marshal of his fight. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Give thanks and glory to the Lord's holy name. God is the Lord, the marshal of his fight. Amen.
again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Have mercy.
All in remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
For thine is the majesty, and thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Where is our
us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Mercy.
Calling to remembrance our all-holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever-Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God. Counted worthy to hear the holy gospel, let us pray to the Lord God.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, stand upright, let us hear the holy gospel.
Peace be to all.
And to thy spirit.
Reading from the holy gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to thee, O Lord.
On the first day of the week, early dawn, the women went to the tomb, taking the spices which they had prepared, and certain others with them. And they went in, and they did not find the body of the Lord Jesus. While they were perplexed about this, behold, two men stood by them in dazzling apparel. And as they were frightened and bowed their faces to the ground, the men said to them, "Why do you seek the living among the dead? He is not here, but has risen. Remember how he told you, while he was still in Galilee, that the Son of Man must be delivered into the hands of sinful men, and be crucified, and on the third day rise again. And they remembered his words. And returning from the tomb, they told all this to the 11 and to all the rest. Now it was Mary Magdalene and Joanna, and Mary, mother of James, and the other women with them, who told this to the apostles. But these words seemed to them an idle tale, and they did not believe them. But Peter rose and ran to the tomb. Stooping and looking in, he saw the linen cloths by themselves, and he departed, wondering at what had happened.
Chrysostom, Athanasius, Cyril, and John the Merciful, Patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Spiridon Trimethos, and and Nectarios of Pentapolis, the wonder workers, of our fathers among the saints, Tikhon, Patriarch of Moscow, and Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the trophy bearer, Demetrios the mercer, Theodore the soldier, Theodore the general, and Venus the wonder worker, of the higher martyrs, Ignatius the god bearer of Antioch, Charlampos and Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kyriaki, Fotini, Marina, Periskeva, and Irene, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who shone in the ascetic life, of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the martyrs Sophia and her daughters, Faith, Love, and Hope, martyr Agathoclea, higher martyrs Heraclides and Myron, bishops of Tamasus in Cyprus, venerable Anastasios, Hysterion of Cyprus, and Eusebios of Cyprus, the bishop whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners who make our supplications unto thee, and have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Christ our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Cyprus division. mercy upon us. Amen.
Thank you.
let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Worship at his pastor, for he is all.
Master.
Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and through ages of ages.
Amen.
In peace let us pray to the Lord. Above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who with faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter therein, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, for the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, and for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the
Lord.
For the President of the United States, for all civil authorities, and for our armed forces everywhere, especially for Peter, Joshua, Ronnie, Adam, Benjamin, Andrew, Thaddeus, Skyler, and Connor, let us pray to the
Lord.
For this city and for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and for their salvation, for those under persecution for the faith, for our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace. Calling to remembrance our all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Our God.
is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
stand upright.
Let us pray to the Lord.
For holy art thou, our God, and at the knee we ascribe glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever,
and unto ages of
man is not justified by works of the law, but through faith in Jesus Christ. Even we have believed in Jesus Christ in order to be justified by faith in Christ, and not by works of the law. Because by works of the law shall no one be justified. But if, in our endeavor to be justified in Christ, we ourselves were found to be sinners, is Christ then an agent of sin? Certainly not. But if I build up again those things which I tore down, then I prove myself a transgressor. For I, through the law, died to the law, that I might live to God. I have been crucified with Christ. It is no longer I who live, but Christ who lives in me. And the life I now live in the flesh, I live by the faith in the Son of God, who loved me and gave himself for me.
Peace be to thee, and read it. Said to them, truly I say to you, there are some standing here who will not taste death before they see the kingdom of God come with power.
Sort of thing. We ought to at least realize this is important. And we ought to realize that if we had to write that one page essay and we weren't sure what we would put there, we're probably in trouble, right? This is no joke. If we did give answers as to what the cross means in our life, would they be what we really do, or would they be theory, our best intentions? Something that we should think about on this day. It's true, of course, that the words of our Lord can become so familiar to us that they fail to register. We just, the deacon reads them, and oh yeah, it's cross words, which is, okay, a puzzle. But not so, I'm sure, with the original hearers of this message. You know, it was, I think, astonishing to those who first heard these words. Because in the ancient Roman world, if you saw someone bearing his own cross, it could only mean one thing, that this was a condemned criminal going off to a horrible execution. So this would really mean that our Lord was standing before his disciples saying, if any man would come after me, let him count himself as a condemned criminal and about to die and follow me. Now that's something you don't miss, you know. That's not something you stand as the deacon reads and not pay attention to. Count yourself like one about to be executed. You know, when you see the words in that way, they become once again the radical call of Jesus Christ to the cross, to abandon our love for this world in order to walk with him. There is no other way. Jesus doesn't say the cross is for those who are especially committed, for those who want extra credit, you know, this kind of thing. No, he says if anyone would follow me, deny yourself, take up your cross, follow me. When you think about it, a condemned man, someone carrying his cross to be crucified, is a person that, you know, he's just completely out of options at that point, right? He can no longer choose what to do, where to go in his life. What he wants, in fact, no longer matters, for he must do the will of a power far greater than himself. And if you forget about death for just a moment, you realize, I hope, that this idea of giving up our options is more frightening sometimes than death itself. That's scary to us. I mean, it's hard for us to conceptualize death when Christ says, take up your cross. But what we think is, give up your stuff. Give up your will. Give up, you know, what you want to do and follow me. And that scares us. We like our freedom to choose. In fact, we actually love our freedom to choose to the point of making it idolatry. To do what we want, to live however we please, are considered the most basic human entitlements. And today, I suppose we'd have to add, to believe whatever you want, because orthodoxies, whatever they may be, are seldom considered binding on people anymore. If you hold your own personal views on doctrine, on human sexuality, on reproductive rights, you are apparently not only free, but actually morally obligated to put your views above that of your church. It's not necessarily that your views are better, but they're your views, and that's all that matters. Of course, this has nothing at all to do with Christianity, but it is the religion of self, the worship of self, the worship of our freedom, the worship of our own ideas, our own will, and everything else is the idolatry. It is the worship of the Antichrist that we all participate in, the Antichrist that we all serve, unless we have undertaken to die to self to live with Christ. The call of Christ is meant to be astonishing because it calls for a clean break. Stop worshiping the false gods and worship the true God. It is meant, like cold water, to rouse the sleeper from a life of slavishly following our own desires, our own will. And what is a man to do besides follow his own will in life? The only other option is to consider himself already dead with no other will than God's to obey. And this is the call to the cross that we so often forget. Again, when Jesus calls us to take up our cross, he doesn't say be religious, put a bumper sticker on your car, whatever. It's a call to sacrifice our will, deny yourself, forfeit yourself, so that you can follow God, so you can follow Christ. By habit, I think, we always try to save our own life, that is to live the way we want to live, by our own thoughts, by our own feelings, by our own purpose. That's what people do. That's what we do. We don't often challenge that habit to seek what God wants, to do God's will. It's not easy to serve the true God in place of ourselves. And when I say we, I mean, of course, me, maybe you, and I don't mean to imply that you or I never follow Christ or that we always put our will ahead of God's, but I certainly recognize this one thing, and maybe you do too, that the limiting factor in my steadfast obedience to Christ is nothing other than my own stubborn self-will. Things that I choose to do instead of follow Christ, or to ignore instead of following Christ. This is because of one basic problem, one shortfall. I do not consider myself a dead man. I don't think of myself as crucified with Christ, and this life is no longer mine. That's what I need to change. This is what the call is. Take up your cross. Consider yourself about to be executed. You have no choice. You have no will. And Jesus is asking us to do that, to make that decision, to serve him. What this means, of course, is that we need to live deliberately. We need to live orthodoxy on purpose. Our faith should not be an afterthought, but the first thought in all things. We need to develop an active faith rather than a passive one. And this is like the difference between being a driver or a passenger. Passengers all scream all the time, at least in my car. But if your faith is passive, then you merely react to life. This is what a person who is not engaged in faith does. Life is just a constant source of this or that stimulus. I'm happy, I'm angry, I'm jealous, I'm hungry, I'm thirsty, whatever. But, people annoy you, situations trouble you, disappointments abound if you're just a passenger in life, if your faith is not active. But if you live your faith deliberately, actively, if you're mindful of God in every situation, in every encounter with others, then you live that faith. You seek to bring grace to every person and acceptance to every situation that befalls you, to accept that it is God's will. That's such a hard thing, because we react to things. Oh, I wish it wasn't this way. Oh, I hate it when that happens. Instead of saying, maybe this is the will of God. Maybe I should be open to this. But if you're crucified with Christ, this would be your first reaction, if you will. You are crucified with Christ, and the world can do nothing to you. It cannot harm you, because you can't harm one who's already dead. Like Christ on the cross, however, you can do the world much good. The world can't even hurt you. But think of the grace that the crucified man brings into the world. And this is the great mystery of our faith. Only those who die will live. Right? Am I exaggerating, or is that what Jesus said? You must die in order to live. You must die to this world and become alive in me. And only when we count ourselves as dead every day of our life, and with no other will to do but God's. So we're always questioning our own will. We're always challenging our thoughts, our opinions, our ideas. Never again do I want to hear somebody say, well, you know, my church teaches this, but who are you to have an opinion contrary to that of the Holy Orthodox faith? And if the church calls us by tradition to do something, we should do that thing. But only when we do the will of God can we be unharmed. Can we be, in a sense, immortal, impervious to the ups and downs of life? Only when we are crucified with Christ are we full of grace and life and joy. Only then do we bring Christ into our lives, into our world, into our relationships. Because the life of Christ in you is greater than the life you had before. It's been said that without the cross, there is no Christianity. And that's, you know, I believe this to be true. We must allow these words of Christ that we heard this morning to astonish us once again. They are startling words. They are challenging words. Lay down your life. Deny yourself. Take up your cross. Abandon all hope. And follow me. Because this is the way to eternal life, to the glory of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace and wisdom.
That guarded always, whether might we be ascribed glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
And to the
God, remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, and all our brotherly brothers, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. Of the United States and all civil authorities, and for our armed forces everywhere, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God, especially for Chance, for Maria Lynn, for Ralph, Debbie, Ruth, and the Archpriest Wayne, for Lauren, Autumn, Stephanie, Mary, Michelle, Kelsey, Stacy, Claire, Christina, for Ronnie and Rebecca, that they have mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, pardon and remission of their sins. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the Orthodox servants of God departed this life, especially for Harry and for those of our loved ones whom we commemorate this morning, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Our prayer unto the Lord. For the precious gifts now set forth, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house and those who with faith, reverence, and the fear of God enter therein, let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all tribulation, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Let the whole day be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord. A faithful guide, guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. Grant this, O Lord. Guardian remission of our sins and transgressions, for all things good and profitable for our souls, and for peace in the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant this, O Lord.
We may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance. For a Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, peaceful, and a good defense before the awesome judgment seat of Christ, let us
have
calling to remembrance our all holy immaculate, most blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God. Love one another, that with one accord we may confess.
Thank you.
us who has bring us from non-existence into being. And when we have fallen away, has raised us up again. And has not ceased to do all things until now has brought us back to heaven and has endowed us with thy kingdom which is to come. For all these things we give thanks unto thee and to thy only begotten Son and thy Holy Spirit. For all things of which we know and of which we know not. And for all the benefits bestowed upon us both manifest and unseen. And we give thanks unto thee also for this ministry, which thou hast vouchsafed to receive in our hands, even though there stand beside thee thousands of our angels and then thousands of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six-winged, many-eyed, soaring aloft, borne on their pinions, singing the triumphal hymn, loudly proclaiming and saying,
thank you.
thou grant unto thy holy churches in peace, safety, honor, health, and length of days, and rightly dividing the word of thy truth. City and countryside, and of those who in faith dwell therein. Be mindful, O Lord, of those who travel by sea, by land, and by air, of the sick, the suffering, the captives, and their salvation. Be mindful, O Lord, of those who bear fruit and do good works in thy holy churches, and who remember the poor. And upon us all, send forth thy mercies. Grant us with one mouth and one heart to glorify and praise thine all honorable and majestic name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with you all.
Have been offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord. That our God, who loves mankind, receive them upon his holy, heavenly, and ideal altar for an odor of spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us in return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord, asking for the unity of the faith and the communion of the Holy Spirit. Let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God. Saved by thy mighty hand, to impart unto us thy immaculate body.
sinner, have mercy upon me. O God, be gracious unto me, a sinner, have mercy upon me. O God, be gracious unto me, a sinner, and have mercy upon me.
Let us attend holy things accord a holy.
Thank you. of God, with faith and love draw near.
thy people and bless thine inheritance.
Come this time for
grace and love towards men, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God, and our hope, glory to thee. Of his all-immaculate and all-blameless Holy Mother. By the might of the precious and life-giving cross, as we now celebrate its elevation, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all-laudable apostles, of our Father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and right victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, of Saint Barnabas, patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the martyrs Sophia and her daughters Faith, Love, and Hope, of the martyr Agathoclea, the Hiram martyrs Heraclitus and Myron, bishops of Damasus in Cyprus, the venerable Anastasios of Paris, Tehran, of Cyprus, and Euxicos of Cyprus, the bishop whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints, have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good and loves mankind. Prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us. I looked at these names this morning and I just knew they were going to do a mischief to me. Next, we want to do our monthly memorial for all of our loved ones, family, fellow parishioners who passed away during previous months of September. If you have someone with this, please come up and join us.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. With the spirits of the righteous we pray, give rest to the soul of thy servants and Savior, and preserve them in the life of blessedness, which is with the other.
mercy on us, O God, according to thy great goodness. We pray thee, hearken and have mercy. Again, we pray for the repose of the souls of the servants of God, Marjorie Spiros Fernando, Anush Paul Don, Frank Mary Richard Don, Harold James Andre, Charlotte Anna Fred Gwen Fionn, Ernest Betty Thomas Joy Jimmy, Herman Grant Ora Daniel Sherman, Earl Hilburn, Stefan, for the innocent Christians, and for Devia, who are departed this life, that thou wilt pardon their every transgression, both voluntary and involuntary. That our Lord God will establish their souls with a just repose, the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and remission of their sins. Let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and our God.
Let us
pray to the Lord.
O God, of spirits and of all flesh, who has trampled down death and made powerless the devil and given life to thy world, do thou, the same Lord, give rest to the souls of thy departed servants, Marjorie Spiros, Fernando, Anush, Paul, Don, Frank, Mary, Richard, Don, Harold, James, Andre, Charlotte, Anna, Fred, Gwen, Fionn, Ernest, Betty, Thomas, Joy, Jimmy, Herman, Grant, Aura, Danny, Earl, Gilbert, Stephen, Innocent, Christian, and Devia, who in a place of brightness, a place of verdure, a place of repose, which all sickness, sorrow, and sighing have fled away, pardon every sin which you have committed, whether by word or deed or thought, for thou art good and lovest mankind. For there is no man who liveth and sinneth not, and thy only are without sin, and thy righteousness is to all eternity, and thy law is true. For thou art the resurrection and the life and the repose of thy departed servants, O Christ our God, and unto thee we ascribe glory, together with thy Father who is from everlasting, that all-holy, good, life-giving Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Now, blessed Theotokos, who art most holy, save us. Souls of his servants remembered here this morning, departed this life in his holy mansions, and number them among the just, and have mercy upon us, for as much as he is good and loveth mankind. May thy memory be eternal, Lord, ever memorable brethren, who art worthy of blessedness. Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us and save us.